Welcome to Calbekistan, the place where anybody can learn math. I'm Mr. Calbek, and this is episode 4 of our Solving Crash Course series. Today we're going to be talking about what happens if I have x in more than one place. You can have x on both sides of an equation or multiple places, and we're going to be looking at that. Spoiler alert, combining like terms is your friend. All right, x's are numbers, you can treat them just like numbers. And do anything that you can do with numbers, you can do with variables. All right, so here's another weird situation you might see, where you've got x in more than one place. You have a variable in more than one location. I've got a 5x here and a 3x there and then 10. This is kind of weird looking. You're like, okay, so what do I do? Do I divide by 5 or 3 or what should I do? The truth is, you can think about this like you remember from earlier in our episodes, we thought about this as a balance beam, right? So I've got 14 things over here. But here I've got like 5 random bags of stuff. Here I've got 3 random bags of stuff. So how many bags of stuff do you actually have? I've got 8. There's no reason these have to be separate. You can put them together and make one big thing. So what I want to do here, I want to just pile all those X's together. 5x and 3x gives me 8 x's, okay? A lot of math teachers talk about combining like terms, okay? So if you can combine like terms, please do that. It's gonna make your life a lot easier. And then we've got an easy problem. 8x minus 10 equals 14. That's one that we could have done in episode 3. We're gonna do the opposite of subtracting, which is adding. We're gonna do it to both sides. So leaves me with 8x, negative 10 and positive 10 equals 0. I don't need to write it down. Bring my equal sign down. 14 and 10 makes 24. This is multiplication, remember? Opposite of multiplication is division. All right, so 24 divided by 8, that's just 3. Again, 8 divided by 8 is 1, but I don't need to write that down if I don't want to. But this can be a little bit more challenging. What do I do if I have, if I've got variables on both sides? Okay, that's a challenge. But remember, if it's a variable, it's really just a number. So anything I do with numbers, or anything I do with numbers, I can do the same thing with variables. And for example, the 5 and the 7, I would probably subtract 5 from both sides. I can move that around. Look at this though. I can take the 2x, it's being added. I'm going to do the opposite of adding 2x, and I'm gonna subtract 2x from both sides. Notice over here, I have to think about combining like terms. X's go with X's, numbers go with numbers. That rule is still true. So 2x minus 2x, that's a 0. That cancels out. Now I'm left with 5 equals 7, 3x minus 2x, that's 1x. I've got a very easy question now. Do the opposite of adding 7, that's minusing 7, and I end up with 5 minus 7, that's negative 2. And I don't need to write my x. It doesn't matter if your x is on the right or the left, it's totally fine. You can leave it like that, okay? So if you have a variable on both sides, you can still combine like terms, just like we did in the previous one. So here is the next kind of question that you might see that's a little tricky. Remember, we've got x's on both sides, same situation, but let me show you what happens here, and it can trip you up, so I'd really recommend we think about this. I want to get all my x's together, right? And in the last one, we just subtracted. But look what happens here if I do that. If I subtract 5x from both sides, I end up with 3 minus 5, I end up with a negative 2x. Now you can ask yourself the question, wow, man, do I really want to do that? Let's play this out and see what happens. So I've got negative 8x equals 12 minus 2x. Again, remember how challenging negatives make things? Now I've just made a whole bunch of negatives. If I want to keep solving this, I even get more. 12, I need to subtract it because it's positive. And I end up here with a negative 20 equals negative 2x. Everything's negative right now. And I can actually prevent that. Let me finish this problem, then I'll show you how we can prevent it. Can subtract or divide by 2 here. That cancels out, still makes a 1. Negative 20 divided by negative 2 is actually positive. You get a positive 10. Now we could prevent that whole situation where everything's negative and there's a lot of places to make mistakes if we think about this at the very beginning. There is no reason why you have to subtract the left side from the right side. What if I were to do the opposite? What if I were to subtract the 3x instead? Look what happens here. If I subtract the 3x, now what happens? 5x minus 3x, that's a positive number. My x is positive. I would encourage you, if you have problems like this, ask yourself before you do any math, okay, how can I keep my variable positive? When you keep your variable positive, it's a lot less likely that you'll make a mistake. So ask yourself that question at the very beginning of the problem, and then see what happens here. Now I have a negative 8, I add 8 to both sides, and suddenly everything's positive. This is 0, so I don't have to write it down. 12 and 8 makes 20, divide by 2, and I've got that. Okay, so it's really important that you think about it at the beginning. Ask yourself, just take a minute before we start any problems and say, okay, which way would make the most sense? Okay, and if you ask yourself that question, you're going to save yourself a lot of trouble. And that's true of all math problems. Go ahead and take your time and plan a strategy before you begin. And that's it for today. So join us next time. We're going to be talking about how to deal with more complicated fractions that are mixed in through your problem.